Okay, see you students, today we are going to solve some problems which are depend on the volume of sphere. Okay, so from that first problem is a hemisphere of lead of radius 8 cm is cast into a right circular cone of base radius 6 cm. Determine height of the cone. Correct to two places of decimals. Understood? Here what is given? See, hemisphere of lead of radius 8 cm. Radius is given. Radius of hemisphere is given. Radius, that we will say R, of hemisphere, hemispherical lead is equals to 8 cm is given. So we need to find out here volume. So volume of hemisphere, volume of hemisphere is equals to 2 by 3 into pi r cube. So it will be 2 by 3 into pi. Pi I'm going to keep as it is. Radius is given 8 into 8 into 8 centimeter cube. Okay, so here this product 2 into 8 into 8 into 8 will be, this is cube of 8 is 512, so 512 into 2 1024 upon pi centimeter cube. So this is the volume of a hemispherical lead. Understood? Now so what is given, see, after this is cast into a right circular cone, is cast into a right circular cone of radius 6 cm. So we need to find out volume of right circular cone. Volume of right circular cone is equals to, what is the volume of right circular cone? 1 by 3 pi r square h. So is equal to 1 by 3 into pi as it is, multiply by radius. What is the radius? Radius is given 6 cm, so put directly here 6 into 6 into h, h because height we have to find out. With the help of this height we have to find out. One thing is clear here, that is the volume of hemisphere of lead is equals to the volume of right circular cone. Both the volumes are same, so we can compare volumes. Whatever volumes we have now, that we can compare, then automatically we will get value of h, that is the height. So volume of hemispherical lead is equals to volume of right circular cone. Okay, so now we have that both the values. So 1 by 3 into pi into 6 into 6 into h is equal to 1024 divided by 3. 1024, this is 1024 pi divided by 3. So 1024 divided by 3 into pi. So this pi will be cancelled. Here we can write 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. Okay, so what is remaining here? H is equals to 1024 divided by 3 and 6 twos are 12. So 12 we need to multiply here. Okay, so 1024 divided by 12, 3 is 36. So h is equal to 1024 divided by 36. So it will be this, they are asking answer correct to two places of decimals. So here we can find out this answer. 36 into 2, 8.44 centimeter. Okay, 28.44 centimeters. Okay, so very simple question. Okay, so our second problem is a solid sphere of radius 6 cm is melted into a hollow cylinder of uniform thickness if the external radius of the base of the cylinder is 5 cm and its height is 32 cm. Find the uniform thickness of the cylinder. Okay, uniform thickness. Thickness means, we have seen, thickness means what? External radius minus internal radius, that is equals to thickness. Okay, so first we will think about the first statement. A solid sphere of radius 6 cm is melted. So definitely here we need to find out volume of sphere. Okay, so volume of sphere is equals to रेडियस इज गिवन, रेडियस रेडियस ऑफ स्पीयर ओके इज इक्वल्स टू दैट इज आर इज इक्वल्स टू 6 सेंटीमीटर ओके इज मेल्टेड इन टू अ हॉलो सिलेंडर ओके सो फर्स्ट वी विल फाइंड आउट वॉल्यूम ऑफ स्पीयर वॉल्यूम ऑफ स्पीयर इज इक्वल्स टू 4/3 इंटू पाय आर क्यूब 4/3 इंटू पाय आर क्यूब ओके सो हियर 4/3 इंटू पाय इंटू रेडियस वॉट इज रेडियस 6 सेंटीमीटर सो 6 इंटू 6 ओके सो हियर यू विल गेट दिस इज 6³ 4/3 इंटू 6³ इज 216 मल्टीप्लाय बाय पाय सो हियर वी कैन डिवाइड बाय 3 37s आर एंड 32s आर सो 4 × 72 इट विल बी 288 पाय इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ स्पीयर ओके नाउ वॉट इज आफ्टर दैट वॉट इज गिवन सी मेल्टेड इन टू अ हॉलो सिलेंडर ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म थिकनेस सो वॉट इज द फॉर्मुला विच फॉर्मुला वी यूज टू फाइंड आउट वॉल्यूम ऑफ हॉलो सिलेंडर ओके सो वॉल्यूम ऑफ हॉलो सिलेंडर वॉल्यूम ऑफ हॉलो सिलेंडर इज इक्वल्स टू पाय इन ब्रैकेट आर स्क्वेर माइनस स्मॉल आर स्क्वेर इंटू एच पाय आर स्क्वेर एच हियर ओनली वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द डिफरेंस ओके सो वन मोर थिंग इज गिवन इफ द एक्सटर्नल रेडियस ऑफ द बेस ऑफ द सिलेंडर इज 5 सेंटीमीटर एक्सटर्नल रेडियस इज गिवन External radius, okay. External radius we use capital R. External radius we have taken, we always use capital R. So that I am taking here, external radius is given 5 cm. Okay. Now what is given? See, if the external radius of the base of the cylinder is 5 cm and its height is 32 cm. Height is given 32 cm. Okay. Then find the uniform thickness of the cylinder. These two things are given. Only this internal radius we need to find out. Okay. Here internal radius is small r, but small r is already we have taken here. So internal radius I am taking x. Internal radius we will consider bx. Okay. So now I am going to put here values, that is pi into this is capital R is 5² minus internal radius is x square into height is 32. Okay, so what you will get here? Pi into 25 minus x square into 32. Okay, so this is the volume of cylinder. Definitely again here volume of sphere and volume of this cylinder, hollow cylinder will be same. Okay, so we can compare them, we can equate them. So that is pi into 25 minus x square into 32 is equal to 288 pi. Okay, so here we can cancel both. So now what is remaining here? 32 we can take that side and we can divide 25 minus x square is equal to 288 divided by 32. Okay, so 32 nines are 288. Okay, so what is remaining now here? 25 minus x square is equal to 9. So minus x square is equal to 9 minus 25. So minus x square is equal to minus 16. So we can take that here. That is x square is equal to 16. So x is equal to under root 16 and x is equal to 4. That plus 4 value we will consider because this is radius, internal radius. Understood? So now we have internal radius and external radius they have given us. Okay, we have to find out thickness, uniform thickness. So thickness is equals to R minus R, capital R minus small r, external radius minus internal radius, that is 5 cm minus 4 cm is equals to 1 cm. Okay, so that is the thickness. Understood? So what we have done, uniform, it was given sphere, it was melted. So first we need to find out volume. Okay, it is converted into a hollow cylinder. Height was given, external radius was given. With the help of these two, we have to find out internal radius. Once you will get internal radius, we can find out thickness, because thickness is equals to capital R, external radius minus internal radius. Okay, third problem is a hemispherical bowl of internal radius 9 cm is full of water. This water is to be filled in cylindrical bottles of diameter 3 cm and height 4 cm. Find the number of bottles needed to fill the whole water of the bowl. Okay, value of pi is given, and this question is very simple. Okay, see here what we need to do. A hemispherical bowl of internal radius 9 cm. Okay, hemispherical bowl radius. Okay, here we will consider radius capital R of hemisphere, radius of hemisphere, hemispherical bowl. What is given? 9 cm. Okay, is full of water. Is full of water means we need to find out volume of that hemispherical bowl. Okay, so volume of hemispherical bowl is equals to 2/3 πr³. R we have taken for a radius of hemispherical bowl, because again we are going to think about cylinder, so that time again we will use R, so that time we can use small r, so for that we have taken here capital R. Okay, so now here we have to put the values. What is given? 2/3 into pi, we will keep as it is. Radius, what is radius given? 9 cm. So 9 into 9 into 9 cm³. Okay, so here we can divide 3 3s are 9. Okay, 9 9s are 81. 82 multiply by 81 into 3 pi centimeter cube. Okay, so it will be 486 pi centimeter cube. So that is the volume of hemispherical bowl. Okay, what is given after this? This water is to be filled in cylindrical bottles of diameter 3 centimeter and height 4 centimeter. Find the number of bottles needed. Okay, so what we will do now, we will find out volume of cylindrical bottle. Okay, when you will get volume of cylindrical bottle, that time volume of hemispherical bowl divided by volume of cylindrical bottle, then automatically you will get number of bottles. So very simple question. So now we will find out here volume of cylindrical bottle. Okay, so what is the formula? We use pi r square h. Here we will use small r. Okay, so what is radius? Radius is given 3, diameter is given 3 centimeter. Okay, diameter is 3 centimeter, so radius will be 3/2 cm, and height is given 4 cm. Height is given 4 cm. So we will put the given values in the formula, that is pi as it is we will keep, multiply by radius is 3/2 into 3/2, because square r square multiply by height is 4. Okay, so here we can 2 2s are 4, this 2 2 will be cancelled, so what is remaining? 3 3s are 9 pi centimeter square. Okay, so this is the volume of cylindrical bottle. Understood? So now we need to divide here volume of hemispherical bowl divided by volume of single cylindrical bottle, then we will get number of bottles. So number of bottles is equals to 486 pi divided by 9 pi. Okay, so here this pi will be cancelled. 9 5s are 45, remain 336, 9 4s are 36, so 54 is the answer, correct answer. Okay.